But yeah, that's, I just thought that that fact was very funny to me personally. I don't know about everybody else. You know, I heard that like at Evo there was like a pool that was pretty much all Yoshimitsus.
There's except I keep for seeing Boom. Pools like that. Combo Breaker, my pool was all Talons.
Mm-hmm.
At Evo, I saw some Mina pools. A lot of times, there's a Nightmare pool.
But yeah, MT Fighter going to be going up against Count Ravioli, the Astroth player.
Count Ravioli.
So, you know, I mean, obviously he's on the winner's side, but I was watching a lot of casuals, and he is very, very good at making you fear what his setup is.
He looks a lot like Cloud. He plays like him, too. So, Count Ravioli. Sounds like an EMP.
Like that back turn, but yeah, it does sound like an EMP.
MT Fighter getting a launch, though.
Yeah. Got him at the... Oh, yeah. 50-50 at that point, right? Like we were talking about earlier.
Yeah,
it's so little life.
Shangwa is one of those characters where you can have a deep bag of tricks. She has so many stances and tricky things to do.
Yeah, it definitely what's really tricky is that 2-2-B that he just did to avoid the throw right there. Yeah. That move is super good. She's not as strong as she once was, but she's still got tools. 2-2-B, but no dice right there. You know, Count Ravioli didn't bite that time. Going to get 3-B into the CE here. Stop me! I remember when I heard that every 30 seconds at every tournament
just
back in the day. Just kidding.
It's just a prank.
Just a prank, bro. Yeah. Okay, feigning the break attack right there. Go catch it.
Ouch. You see how much that did?
And caught the tech twice. Again,
he's doing it
same
again.
Throw.
One.
He's got two bars as well. You got to think about that, right? So Soul Charge could come out. Maybe not Soul Charge. Maybe CE, right?
Oh.
No GI. There's the break attack, though. Okay, I like that. Yeah, using the horizontal lows, right, to catch steps and just get some chip damage if possible.
He kept it patient right there and solid.
Oh, ooh, wow. Yo, raw start? 3-B? It's like that?
Raw launch.
Oh, wow. That's the first time it's actually tracked well enough to actually hit her.
Yeah, he's been stepping in around it perfectly.
Yeah, there's the GI. Point. Okay, he was looking for the re-GI in that situation. No dice, though. Okay, what's the mix-up? There it is. Front escape. Revenge grab. It's the low. Yeah, there it is, right? You were talking about how he's been stepping it and stepped it again. What a step right there, though, right?
This has to kill.
Can't stop me. Yeah, it was raw, so there was no scaling on that one like the other combos where it's a launch. So that's
a pretty,
was that three straight rounds?
Pretty convincing first game.
No round brown?
What's Count Ravioli going to do to adapt?
He started to pick up a lot more steam in the later half. You know, when he started to get the grabs, it was a little more difficult for MT Fighter to be able to tech them. But when he finally switched over to back throw, he was just not ready for it. Okay. Big damage. Yeah, I was going to. It was either big damage or he was dead. I didn't know which, but apparently it was he was dead.
I like to see some ring outs.
Yeah, well, that's the position for it for sure. Okay. Yeah, challenge, right? Oh, caught him on the forward throw again. At this point, you just keep doing forward throw, right? Right?
Yeah.
See?
Hey.
This is back throw if he does it again. I was going to say. Okay.
I was going to say, quit spoiling it, man.
You know, I have the script. Oh, and there's the tech on the back escape. But yeah, see, it's real hard for you to press buttons in that kind of situation. You got to make sure it's your fastest if you're in something like that. But there's very little health left for Count Ravioli. Tried to go into Crybaby, but there's the charge. Oh, Crybaby to catch him on the corner circles.
MT Fighter is in his head now. You can't win like that and not be in someone's head.
I mean, I hope Count Ravioli is used to people trying to get in your head like that. Because, you know, that's the mark of somebody who's in top eight, right? Is being able to compose themselves after something like that happens. Okay. Yes, that's big. Yeah, I think he's trying to put him in ring out position, yeah. So much damage.
Okay, MT Fighter not out of it.
Wait, he doesn't have any health left, what? Where's the pixel? But yeah, 3-B right into CE. It scales. Just not enough.
Just kidding.
And I mean, look, she literally did not have health left.
Yeah. MT Fighter got the plot armor.
Nice duck there on the grab. I think he might have also been too far away, but he was definitely ducking there. Oh, ducks on the horizontal.
Slickest duck I've ever seen.
Okay, nice. Trying to force him to duck whatever the setup was, and then 3B, but no dice right there from Tom Ravioli. Gonna activate Soul Charge, and we starting to see how this can turn it around. I like this.
He's really not letting Astaroth get started.
No revenge moves, right? Using either lows or strong hits. Okay, Soul Charge activated. Trying to close it out right here. Wants to make it to the Winner's Finals. Oh. It does exactly that with the duck on the throw. MTFIGHTER.
Super clean game right there.
And honestly, so if I'm going to be real with you, that that set right there versus Count Ravioli looked a lot like the Winner's Finals of his pool. He completely controlled his opponent. He had very strong thoughts on when to duck and when to sidestep, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, he took it emphatically.
For sure. Definitely very strong defense, too. Knowing when to duck, when to sidestep.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just defense, everything. Movement, and he was ready to get every punish to the fullest that he could get it every single time. That was definitely just like a top 8 winners like player.
Yeah.
So he's going to move on to the Winner's Finals now. So your Winner's Finals is going to be Party Wolf versus MTFIGHTER. You're saying that Party Wolf has been going Cassandra the whole time, so I assume we're going to then see Cassandra versus X. Obviously, Party Wolf has other characters available to him.
Yeah, however, he has the option to switch if he would like to.
Yeah, and I mean, MTFIGHTER has been stuck with Zheng Hua since the beginning, so I would be interested to see if he switches at all, but I doubt I even see it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It could be hype. We'll see what happens. Might have a pocket, Sasuelmo or something.
Oh, my God. I love me some Sasuelmo. That's the character I play, so. Yeah.
Do you know who we have up next?
It's hard to tell from here because they're facing the other way. But here, I'm just going to check the bracket because it would just be obvious at that point, right?
Yep.
So it's going to be Rids versus Crywolf.